So, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I welcome you all to today's program. As you know, this is a Zoom meeting we are arranging, focusing mainly for radiation technologies, but this will cover the COVID-19 situation, handling of patient safety by the total radiation of the department. And we are very happy that we have two overseas faculty, Dr. J.P. Agarwal from Tata Memorial Hospital and also Gurvinder Singh. Our today program will be chaired by our Oncology Club President, Professor M.A. Hai, and it will be moderated by Dr. Mustafa Aziz Shumon. So now may I request Dr. Mustafa Aziz Shumon to start the session. And before that, I want to express one personal gratitude to Karthik and Samuel, who really helped me to organize this. On offset of this Thanksgiving, I am requesting Mustafa to start the session with the comment from Professor M.A. Hai, sir. Mustafa.
Someone unmute.
Thank you, Kamal Bhai. As we want to start, it's sharp 2:45. May I request our chairman, Professor M. Hai sir, to say a few words, and after his words, we will start our program. Professor M. Hai sir.
Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Good afternoon. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. I'm happy to see that about 100 of the technologists have registered for the session. Hopefully, everybody will be joining. Till now, 52 has joined. And my gratitude to Dr. JP and Gurvinder, they are our good friends, although always they respond to our call. They are already happy, have all joined here. We are starting a very nice session today. First of all, I want to say all the participants, please keep your microphone mute. Talk with opening, unmute it. When you want to put any question, only that you can open it and put question. Okay, now someone please start.
Thank you, sir. To all participants, as discussed by our Professor M. Hai sir, please mute your microphones. And if you need to discuss any question, just put it in the chat box so we can discuss it later. Now we want to start our program. This program is totally designed for the radiation therapy technologists, and our topics will be in the pandemic area of COVID, how we will treat our patients. So our today's faculty, Mr. Gurvinder Singh, I don't think that he needs a description for him. He is a very familiar figure over here, particularly for the radiation therapy technologist. May I request Mr. Gurvinder Singh to present his presentation. Mr. Gurvinder Singh.
Yeah, good afternoon. I feel delighted to be on this platform among all of you. I express my gratitude to Dr. Kamaluddin, Professor Hai, and no doubt Dr. J.P. Agarwal from India. Thank you very much for this academic event. And I think for presentation, you have to run from your side because I will not be able to run.
Okay, sir. May I request Mr. Regan?
Yeah.
So please share your slide, so that we can proceed.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Yes. So as we all are aware that COVID has affected whole world medically and financially. So we need to understand to control it and to win the result. So few questions comes to our mind that how close to close is sufficient in our general life when we are at home, when we are coming out of home, going to markets, when we are going to office, and then further focusing our work practice in radiotherapy. In that case, how much fast in patient setting we are matching all coordinates as per the treatment plan precisely and safely. So these are the matters which we have to understand, that during this epidemic, how we have to proceed. Next, please. So let us understand what is, it is an ongoing pandemic caused by severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2. Highly infectious, mainly transmitted through droplets generated when an infected person coughs or sneezes or exhales. These droplets fall on floors or surfaces, and then it is infecting by breathing. If we are in close proximity of someone who has COVID-19 or by touching a contaminated surface, and most important is then touching eyes, nose or mouth. So in that case, chances are there. So what is resulting? It may give mild illness, like some people very ill, and the disease can be fatal for older and those who are having pre-existing medical conditions such as BP, heart problem or diabetes. Therefore, situation need to take a calculated risk to manage smoothly in the interest of safety of patients, attendants, visitors, and staff. Having alertness all the times. Next, please. So this webinar is a very good platform to provide the community with insights in radiotherapy development during COVID pandemic. In order to avoid movement of personnel for academic update from departments, so we can minimize the exposure to unguarded surface. Next, please. We need to know the focusing, we have to focus the ways from where these infections are coming, like getting, whether we are getting infection from home and community, or we are getting infection from COVID-19 patients, or we are getting infection from each other. Because once we are able to identify from where we are getting these infections, then efficiently we can make a management and better management to control it. Next, please. So RTTs are frontline staff on machines, must strictly follow appropriate face masks, face shields, gloves, caps, and hand hygiene. Why? Because this is going to spread through asymptomatic patients before they are identified that they are having corona. So median incubation time is 4 to 7 days, and during this period infection may progress many persons. So we have to be careful taking the attentions. Patients are in high risk for mucus exposure. Those who are having laryngeal tubes need attention. Weak immunity of cancer patients due to the use of chemotherapy, radiotherapy, surgery need more attention. Staff exposure, their workflow, groups have to be made prepared so that if anybody is exposed, then stop working and give a backup staff. So this attentions we have to take care. Exchange of daily appointment slip card on machine area or OPD area, wherever we are doing, we should avoid. And if unit is down, then avoid cross-contamination by staggering the patients, by staggering the engineers' arrival to perform the repair. Gathering of patient in RT waiting area may further increase the risk of infection. That attention has to be taken care. Masks should be compulsory for all patients and their accompanying caregivers. First, go through a temperature checkpoint at the outpatient gateway. If fever detected, then refer to a specialized clinic in the same center. Next, please. So we have to understand that how much we are careful in our actual day-to-day work practice while interacting among each other. For example, whether we are in relaxed mood, we have not properly mask not worn properly, or social distancing not maintained, groups chatting, food together in clusters. So we have to adapt ourselves to live without getting infected and without infecting others. So that practice we have to follow. Next, please. When we are coming unique to radiotherapy, then we all know that radiotherapy treatments anywhere in the body is being done with qualified professionals. So cancer patients are planned with minimum margin in current practice by escalating higher radiation doses so that effective therapeutic ratio is gained. A multi-fraction course of treatment which cannot be postponed, because by each week of delay translates to 14% cancer control. This is as per the published data. So delay means we are losing the patient's survival rate. So radiotherapy side effects is mimicking to COVID-19 symptoms like low-grade fever, cough, sore throat, maybe due to mucositis in head and neck, and many lung cancer may have respiratory symptoms of varying degree. So that has to be another challenge for the community of radiotherapy. Manpower planning to keep them safe from the disease and to prevent burnout is a challenge. RTT need to make sure that all immobilization devices in use, includes mask and hardware, can be cleaned and disinfected with Acroseft disinfectant, that is sodium dichloroisocyanurate recommended by WHO. So you apply with a soft cloth after use of the devices to avoid contamination. Cleaning the pre-cuts on regular basis can remove the layer of dead bacteria that may have formed on the positioning devices. Next, please. So there are few recommendation for the lunch break staggering, sitting 6 feet between two persons or four persons sitting in four corners of the room, and if possible eat alone. Discourage sharing of lunch from common tiffin. For sitting, vaccine chair surface can be easily disinfected, so can be used in better way. Entry exit doors, reduce touching of handles and knobs, and when going to washroom, then extra caution while opening and closing taps to prevent contamination. Soap up the tap in the beginning and after washing hand, then clean tap knob and close it. Next, please. Now, if you are wearing long chains, finger rings, leather belts, purse, and other accessories which cannot be washed at the end of the day, must be avoided. Hair tie up while in hospital and wear a cap all times. Care of mask, goggles and face shields. Not to touch the inner surface with bare hands. Sanitize face shield and goggles before and after use and share them in a proper place. Store them in a proper place. Do not leave them lying here and there. Label them with your name tag. Carefully wear and remove a mask by holding the straps, but without touching the surface of the mask. Next, please. If you are using lift, first you should think to avoid using lift to the extent if possible and use stairs. Otherwise, if you want to use, then make sure it is not too crowded. If it is crowded, wait for another turn. And all the people standing in a lift should be facing the wall. And as far as possible to avoid each other's breath, use a tissue paper or pen or gloved finger to press the lift button. If using stairs, do not hold the railing of the staircase. And when you are using mobile phone, regular sanitization several times a day or keep in a sealed transparent plastic pouch. Also, it is preferred to use speaker to avoid close contact with the mouthpiece, which may be possibly contaminated. Next, please. So the current positioning and immobilization devices needs proper sanitization before use to radiotherapy patient. That we have to understand. Next, please. Discourage placing of devices in this manner. Next, please. Encourage the distancing among the all the devices which we are using. Next, please. If you are involved in treating the COVID positive patient, then it is important to know the order of wearing the PPE. First, step one is hand hygiene. Step two, put mask, like this. So there are 7 steps, very important. And when you are taking off PPE, then the steps again important to avoid infection for self and for others. Next, please. Can you click first slide so that one video will run?
Regan, first slide.
Yeah, any there are two videos. What I have done, I have shooted the video how we are doing in disinfecting our accessories daily, what we are using for headrest, all-in-one devices or fit mask. So every day in a day, 2-3 times in a day, we are doing with different kind of way, and then at the end of the day, we are using in a different kind of way to clear any kind of infection in the department, and then we are locking the department. And for the next day, again morning, we are safe in our work practice. So these two videos I have prepared to show that how we are practicing actually on our areas. So I think it is not.
We are having some problems. So what we will do, we will send it to all the participants so they can see it.
Yeah. No problem. Next, please. So let us have to make some standard operating procedures, policies that yes, in the department, how we should work during this epidemic. So first of all, we should be careful that no unwanted item should be stored in the area. Do not entertain any person if not covering face with mask or clean cloth. Patient screening while coming for radiotherapy treatment limited to one accompanying person. Staff screening while entering to work. The radiation treatment room and nearby area should be thoroughly disinfected during treatment intervals, which I have shown in the videos. RTTs have a very regular close contact with large number of patients every day. So need to be careful more while performing precise sets on planning and treatment units with proper staff schedule. Highly specialized equipment which we are using have high volume of patient every day. So there is a large area of potential contamination. So you need to make the SOPs that how you are going to make safe that region. The next last is physical separation, mixing of number of patients, groups in waiting area between patient, those who are active on treatment and those in follow-up with the organized carefully. So we have to make these guidelines. And I think once we are able to make guidelines and we are able to follow these guidelines, so we can be safe, we can work safe, and we can meet safely. Thank you very much. I have tried to take these experience sharing with you. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, Gurvinder ji. I think from your presentation, all of us definitely be benefited. Now I would like to request Professor JP Agarwal sir to say a few words regarding today's discussion in pandemic area, how we can be safe and we can safely deliver to our patients. Professor JP Agarwal sir.
Thank you, Suman. I'm so grateful seeing all old friends, though it may be virtual, but I really appreciate it. There are so many, I can remember the names, right? Very senior ones, Dr. Hussain and Dr. Hai, the Bacon Light, you know. We are so grateful. On a personal note, to begin with, please, please stay safe. And probably how to treat patient safely during the COVID pandemic is a topic. So I don't know. How to be safe during the COVID pandemic. How to be safe? If I am safe, others will be safe. That's what I am trying to say. I'm an average guy, you know. If I am safe, others are safe. So I think I wanted to say why this topic, basically. And there are a couple of key words here. One of them is safety. And you people are really, really very smart than me. I'll tell you the reason. If you can walk down in a Dhaka busy traffic, and you come out safely, that means you are a smart guy. You know what I'm trying to say. Yes, so a word safety itself, or a safely, it means there is some danger somewhere, or there can be a perceived danger somewhere, and then we have to take a necessary actions to see that we are not hurt, and as well as the other thing is also important, that we don't hurt others from our action. So that is the basic fundamental. And as such, a pandemic, everybody understands, but it is a widespread business, and technically it is going to affect everybody and everybody across the continents, across the geographies. And very beautifully said by Gurvinder, what is COVID? In a simple terms, people will be much more literate now, that it is a virus with a lipid coating over it. And it is something called a crown. That is the reason it is called corona. Okay. So that is as simply as I can make it. You all are radiation oncologists, radiation physicist, radiographers, and you are doing a supreme job. So my basic fundamental of understanding, and it cannot be much more important than any of us involved, is we work with radiation day out, day in, day night. Okay. So the basic three principles of radiation protection, if we can apply here, that is the distance. If we are away from each other, the likelihood that we will get infected is unlikely. The second is shielding, that is the mask. Okay, a shielding protects most of the time everything. Third thing is the time. Okay. The likelihood, if you are even in a contact, like I am treating a patient on a machine, and if I do it very efficiently within less than 10 minutes or so, even if he's a positive patient and I have taken all precaution, I will ever be called as a high risk contact. Okay. I will always be a low risk contact. It is, the WHO says 15 minutes, right? 15 minutes of contact time. If I am wearing a good mask, good shielding, working efficiently, in turn seeing the patients, the likelihood I will be ever called a high-risk contact is remote. So shielding, time, and distance are important. Lastly, you know, the virus came. And we understood, it is hardly 6 months now. The whole thing is unfolding. So what is another beauty of protection from this is washing, as Gurvinder was saying. a chemical way of understanding things. Everybody does their washing of the clothes, you know. Some does a dry cleaning and some does a wet cleaning. A wet cleaning is simple by the soap and water, right? And that is probably the most easiest way and the cleanest way that you do it for at least 20 seconds. I would prefer a 30 second, you know. You can make your own song. We can hear a national song in our mind and in our heart. And believe me, that's the service we'll do to ourselves and everybody. We can do a dry cleaning business. Everybody has given their clothes to laundry, etc., right? That is a bit more expensive to the community, and that is nothing but an alcohol rub, you know? So that's my easiest way of understanding to a common layman purpose. There are four fundamentals: cleaning, distance, shielding, and the time. If we follow this principle, believe me, we will keep our patient safe, we will keep our family safe, and we will be safe. Okay, that's what I wanted to say. And now, Suman, back to you.
Thank you, sir. As always, very precious words from you. Very informative and very, and the words from your experience. Always, I always want to share that Professor J.P. Agarwal says from his experience. So thank you, sir. I just want to share a few personal experience from me. A few days ago, the Chinese team came from China to Bangladesh, and they're from such institute where their percentage of employees infection was zero. So we wanted to ask what was the magic, what was the cause, and they said that the lock your face and your hand. So the beauty, so the main essence to get free from this infection, probably to know how to lock your face and to lock your hand. Now the session is open for the participants to ask any question. So if you have any question, please inbox us so that we can discuss it with our renowned faculties. So if any question is there, I request all the participants to write it in the inbox.
Okay, in the meantime, the questions are coming. Can I ask anybody who has treated a positive patient?
Sir, with radiation therapy or sir, in any way? I am working in a COVID hospital, sir. I have already treated more than 600, 700 patients. Good. Not with radiation therapy, sir.
God bless you. Take care. Okay. Good, good. Help
Thank
them.
You, sir.
So any patients of COVID with cancer?
Yes, sir. Sir, I just want to share, sir. I thought that I would discuss it later. Sir, do you think that cancer patients are really special for this COVID?
Gurvinder, you want to take it?
Sir, from my experience, I just want to share. Later, I will get your answer. So from my experience in Bangladesh, we have treated more than 70 patients from my personal experience, and very few patients experience a grave result. Most of them are cured in a very usual manner, as usual the other patients. So I think, at least in Bangladesh, for cancer patients, COVID is not a very serious issue. Sir.
Okay. So maybe that TMC is one of the exclusive cancer hospital, and we take care of the patients with cancer and the COVID here.
Sir.
Also, like Rajiv Gandhi is also one of the exclusive cancer hospital, and they also admit the both. So it's basically a hybrid hospital, you know, both COVID and non-COVID together. So we have to segregate them. That is the first fundamental what we have done it here. And So patients who are actually positive, okay, RT-PCR positive, we don't treat at this point of time unless and until it's an emergency for them. If they have become a COVID positive, or they are known COVID and now they have resolved, so we can treat them. And generally, that is one of the rules is around 4 weeks. So definitely, after being a positivity, so we do a test something like 2 weeks. Some of you can do it 3 weeks because the test cost and the availability is limited. So the likelihood at 3 weeks to get a negativity is very high. You spare one test. Okay.
Yes.
So, and after a couple of days of that, you can certainly treat it. But likelihood that at 2 weeks to treat them is very, very uncommon. So we have not treated, I have not treated a patient who is a frank COVID positive, a known COVID positive. They may be asymptomatic COVID, we don't test right now routinely. But a known frank COVID positive, we are not treated right now. And the reason is simple. It is a protection of the staff as well as healthcare workers. Okay? Because we are treating on a regular basis all the patients routinely. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Have any questions?
Yes. So from Gurvinder ji.
Yeah, I agree with Dr. JP what he says, because we have an experience also in similar way. We got two patients treated till date COVID positive. So our oncologist very well, they waited for in one patient, the patient was having a CA rectum. And the patient was diagnosed after surgery in May. The patient is COVID positive. Then our oncologist waited for 4 weeks at least just to make the clearance from its COVID. But unfortunately, patient was continued for more than a month is positivity. So at last, then it was started due to some, you know, maybe better oncologist can say. And in similar way, there was a CA pyriform fossa, head and neck cancer, and it was a cord compression, neck cord compression. Patient was having neck cord compression, and then again, after coming to positive report, the oncologist waited. But then in emergency, we were supposed to give two fractions. And then, what I mean to say, what Dr. JP says, we also follow the same similar guidelines.
Thank you, sir. By this time, we have received few questions from the participants. So question from Istifkar Hussain. Are you disinfecting couch after treating every patient? So regarding the disinfection of couch, what policy you are adopting right now?
Gurvinder.
Gurvinder ji.
when we are using the immobilization devices, then if we are using, there is a base plate, which is known as a all-in-one. So all-in-one we are placing on for all patients on the couch. So what we are used to do it, we have previously when COVID was not there, our appointment pattern time was 20 minutes for each patient. So from 7 o'clock morning to 7 o'clock p.m., we were able to use more volume of patients. But now since volume also has gone, number of patients down, so we have made a spacing pattern 30 minutes. And in that 30 minutes, we are trying to keep maximum in all patients using the Acroceft, that material, which our housekeeping department always, each patient after treatment, we clean the AIO and we clean the headrest, and then for next patient, we are used to do it.
Okay. I just add something. Just like what you were doing earlier for the biohazard patients, we used to put a paper, a paper which is non-poral paper. So we used to put papers on all the accessories and ways to treat, like cervix patient with a discharge coming out and all those things. We use those papers as well as we mop it with a disinfectant after every patient, okay, and let it dry. Since the numbers are less right now, so we can cope up. So yeah. What is the plan of action for the future? If the number increases, we will get more accessories. So let it dry it out in the meantime till the next patient comes up. So something like that, we are going to make that arrangement. Okay. I hope that answers to the gentleman or to the person, which I don't know, who asked.
Astefkar. Astefkar.
Oh, yes. Astefkar. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Our next question was asked by our senior teacher, Yusuf Ali sir, and from Arman Reza. So what is the timing of COVID test for RT patient? Particularly, they want to know what would be the COVID test policy regarding before starting radiation therapy.
Okay.
Gurvinder ji, sir. Or JP, sir.
Okay. Gurvinder, shall I take it? Because it's
please,
a testing.
Please.
I hope you don't mind, Gurvinder.
Yeah.
Oh, I want to hear from your institute policy. Okay, a simple thing. Each individual institution has a different policy. That is what Gurvinder was referring as a SOP. Okay, you can have a site-wise policy, you can have an institutional policy, you can have a national policy. So it varies. Like in Canada, few centers have made a policy that before every new patient they are going to take it, they are going to do a test, RT-PCR test, to find out what is the status of the patient. If it is a positive, it goes in a standard quarantine way, symptomatic, asymptomatic. So whatever we are saying about the asymptomatic COVID positive patient who is coming in the radiotherapy OPD, okay, so he or she is tested. And according to the pattern of the national pattern, they either go for, if they are COVID positive, they go in the COVID center, and then they are not treated at that at least 4 weeks until they become a COVID negative. And if they become symptomatic in between, the clinician decides whether to do it or not. So there are some institutes in India who do a rapid antigen test to find out whether they are positive or negative. If they are positive, a further testing is also done to find out, so as to again preserve the patient from unnecessarily going through the whole radiotherapy. There are the third group of the institute which says this RT-PCR is really precious for across the thing. If the patient is asymptomatic, we treat like anybody who is coming as asymptomatic. We are very, very aware of the situation. The question is, you do it for everybody and then say that it is positive or negative, or you do it only in selective group of patients. At Tata Hospital, we are not doing COVID testing for any patient who is walking down in my radiotherapy place. The patient who is going to receive a significant amount of chemotherapy or undergoing surgery at this point of time, we are doing a COVID testing, because the complications associated with those big surgeries and chemo have been very severe in the recent reports. Up to 1/4 of patients died and took a lot of taxing for the institutional things. So what we have decided, that we are doing a super specialist screening for this patient. We screen them twice every time they land up. One is the hospital screening, one is the radiotherapy screening. Okay, the screening is very, very deep in depth, and the reason is very simple. We don't have the luxury of doing lot of tests, and we are a high volume radiotherapy area. Still, I am treating nearly 160 patients till yesterday. Like, I treated 160 patients in my department. I cannot do that amount of tests, because if I do the test, my turnaround time for the whole hospital, which is required for everybody, it's a massive exercise. So that is the reason I am not able to do the test. So what is the other option? So other option is that, as a part of the study, what we are trying to do is trying to find out what will be the prevalence of the patient at this point of time in my department who is coming for radiotherapy. If it is goes beyond certain value, then I have to test for everybody. And if it is below that value at this point of time, I'm going to continue my practice like that. But we are very, very vigilant on that. Okay, so it is the economics perspective, the turnaround perspective, and number of tests. And definitely, it's a very fluid situation, right? Because everywhere, it will be dependent on the number of patients in your city, from where they are coming, and all those business. We are very, very critical that we take precaution rather than do tests indiscriminately. Okay, I hope, Arman, I have answered those questions to you. And
Thank you, sir.
So if you are in doubt at any point of time with absurd symptoms, do a test. And the beauty should be that if you do a test today, your outcome should be given within 24 hours. Okay, if it comes after 5 days or 6 days, it's no use to you. Okay, so that is one of the very important reasons that we are restricting our test. And believe me, in-house, the turnaround time is 8 hours. Means if I have done it in the morning, by evening, I know my test has come. And that is the reason why we are restricting our test, because we don't want to lose for everybody, you know. I hope it's a matter of reasoning, okay? But if you are in doubt, please do it. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Next question from Kamal Bhai. His question is, can we continue radiotherapy in asymptomatic COVID patient who was diagnosed during RT treatment? So should you suggest continue with treatment or stop RT? Asymptomatic patient getting radiation and diagnosed as COVID and the mid time of treatment.
Okay. The moment a patient is diagnosed as positive, okay, you have to put this patient in special areas. Okay. So it is better to avoid all the risk to everybody. Okay. So we are not treating this patient at this point of time. We are not treating this patient at this point of time. So we are going to do some studies as a retrospectively, once they complete, to see the IgG levels, whether they were positive or not. Okay. So that will become as a part of our study, rather than upfront, we are not going to do it. Because the moment we do it, and if we know that it is positive, we have to stop and put them in the COVID center, because that's a rule of the law. And we cannot go beyond the rule of the law, right? So it's better to smart and be very, very vigilant. So it is between the cancer death and the COVID death. COVID death is also going to be there in few percent of the patient, like a 2% overall population-based fatality. But in cancer patient, may go to just a high single digit or even a two digit, depending upon the type of cancers. Okay, so be very vigilant. Don't do test indiscriminately. But most important, the four principles which I told you. Don't forget those four principles. If you follow those four principles, we will become five. That is that we will win the war. Okay.
So another question from Professor Yusuf Ali sir. His question is, how RT room and simulation room to be disinfected? Will radiation exposure eliminate the virus?
All treatment related areas, okay, to be disinfected in a similar way, just like Gurinder pointed out. Everything same. Simulator, the word means simulator, that we are going to do something like a treatment. Okay? So everything same. Everything same. Again, I am reinforcing that fact. Okay, and especially when you are injecting, etc., always wear a shield and a visor. Okay, because you don't know, it will have a splash sometimes. Okay, so always do that way. No question. And regarding the virus will be eliminated, no sir. So we did that exercise because in the beginning when the PPE was a precious item, right, the production in the lockdown time, so we were planning to recycle our PPE. So we did that exercise and the virucidal dose is around 30 gray, around 30 gray single fraction. Okay. That's what we determined in our areas. And there are several studies in the literature for coronavirus from anywhere between 20 gray to 30 gray you need to have to get the sterilization done. So our radiotherapy business right now, no, virus will not be knocked out. Okay, definitely no. Again, a big no.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, please.
Just think of the cockroach who is lying around in your simulator area.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next.
It is a totally clinical question asked by Dr. Savana Kumar Chinnikati. He just asked, is there any experience regarding low-dose RT in COVID patients?
Okay. A purely experimental one, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Gurinder, I am taking it.
I am enjoying.
Shall I?
Yeah, I am enjoying.
Okay. There was some papers which originated from a preclinical area regarding a low dose radiation to the chest, because in historic times people used to give low dose radiation to when there were less antibiotics, etc., in the chest area to do a immunomodulation. And there were some results also in the historic times. Like for tuberculosis also, my great professors probably have treated them with that. And they got outcome because there was some immunomodulation. Even the skin, they may have treated some fungal infection or the resistant one. But we know some effects of radiation which are really, really not so going to be great. So I had a serious letter written on that. But when you don't have anything in the armamentarium like that, you start doing everything and everything is correct, becomes correct. So there are group of people which started from Iran and now from US, from the Emory University. They have done it for some patients. They have done, till my knowledge, what I read the last 2 weeks back, they have done for the 7 patients. And they are reporting good outcomes. And that is what they are reporting. They have done it in patients before the cytokine storm. But believe me, in each individual patient, when the cytokine comp is going to come, we really don't understand, okay, so well. And in my thought, what I wrote, that it is the lung which is getting involved per primum. And if you really want to do it as an oncologist radiation, better to do a whole body radiation, okay, if you want to really avoid a cytokine storm. And there are reports to that also. And if you are a pure doctor, if you treat the oncology, there are several papers from Germany. They are treated with ultra low dose radiation to the whole body to prevent metastases. And there are some good results on that. But believe me, I have not done it. And I'm not a whole chest irradiator. Okay, I'm not for that basically. But there are some people in the world who are doing low dose. I'm not a great believer in that, because we need to treat a very specific cytokines rather than to do a carpet bombing. Okay, so I'm not a guy who are going to do it. At least I can vouch for myself. But there is a literature, very small literature, who are doing it.
Thank you, sir. Due to time constraint, I am not going for further question. Now, I would like to our scientific secretary, Dr. FM Kamaluddin.
There was one made, Suman.
Yes, sir.
There is a question, yes, that in our private chamber, what should we do it?
Yes,
same
sir.
Four principles, sir. And the private chamber is not your private chamber. Technically, everybody is walking down in that chamber. It's a pure public one. Okay. So please do the same business. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Should I proceed, sir?
Yes, please. Sorry for interrupting.
No, sir. You are always welcome. Yes.
Come on. Prasenjit Mandal, I can ask a question for the judge. Prasenjit Mandal.
Prasenjit Mandal, if you have any question, please proceed. Prasenjit Mandal.
Unmute karo.
Prasenjit Mandal, unmute. At first, unmute yourself and ask your question.
Samuel,
বা তোমার কলিগদের যারা কোনো কোশ্চেন থাকলে তোমরা প্রশ্ন করতে পারো.
Come with questions.
Sir, Pranoti Rani ekta question korse. Doctors often say that it is forbidden for a patient to take a bath after receiving treatment. But since this epidemic, everyone has to stay clean. What should the patient do in that case?
So
what would be the policy regarding the bath?
Before you answer, Dr. JP, আমি আপনাকে একটা question করতে চাই. আপনারা আপনাদের রেডিয়েশন রোগীদের কি প্রতিদিন গোসল করতে অনুমতি দেন নাকি দেন না?
Right. প্রণতি রানী.
Dr. JP, can anybody take a bath every day when she or he is taking a radiation? Head and neck, abdomen, chest, whatever it is.
Gurvinder, I think you should take it.
না সব পেশেন্টদের বলি না
গোসল করতে না করো.
Okay, Gurvinder, the question is, should the patient?
মানে বেশিরভাগ পেশেন্টদের গোসল করতে না করি.
I can understand. I think there is no harm in taking the bath if patient takes everyday bath, because in radiotherapy we do the radiotherapy to a normal patient, not having any temperature, no, only very minor skin reactions. So bath should not be discouraged.
Ms. Das, I encourage a patient to take bath. The reason are, I encourage, I am saying that. But we in the Indian subcontinent believe that we should have a vigorous rub through bath, right? So that is generally to be avoided, especially in an area of the radiation which is given, because the skin becomes a fragile like a newborn child, right, at some point of time. So that will not withstand our harsh soap or a spray. So in earlier times, since we used to put some marks on the skin, to avoid those marks to go, we used to say to refrain, put water, etc. on that area. But believe me, it is not the epidemic times. Encourage your patient to take bath. They feel near normal, okay? But in certain conditions, when your patient has some reactions or something, they can preserve that area and still go ahead and take a bath. A lukewarm water bath is a preferable, especially in the hilly areas. They should get a take a bath, and especially in our conditions, where because there is a dirt, etc., is there in commonly in our places. So please, ask them to take a bath.
Sir, আমাদের দেশে একটা কনসেপ্ট আছে স্যার, যে গোসল করলে স্যার আমরা যে মার্কিংটা করি, মার্কিংটা মানে মুছে যায়। সেই সেই পার্সপেক্টিভে আমাদের অনেকেই আমরা দেখছি যে রেডিয়েশন থেরাপি দেওয়ার সময় গোসল করতে নিষেধ করে স্যার, ওই মানে বাট ক্লিয়ার মেসেজ হচ্ছে যে গোসলের সাথে রেডিয়েশন থেরাপির কোনো কন্ট্রাইন্ডিকেশন নাই। দ্যাট ইজ দ্য
আনসার। যদি মাস্ক করতে চান তাহলে আরেকটা ইনসেন্টিভ দিতে পারেন পেশেন্টকে, আপনারা চান করা উচিত, গোসল করা উচিত, তাহলে আপনাকে একটা মাস্ক তৈরি করতে হবে। যদি আপনারা মাস্ক তৈরি করবেন তাহলে অ্যাকুরেসি অফ দ্য ট্রিটমেন্ট ভালো হবে। অ্যাকুরেসি যদি ভালো হয় তাহলে আউটকাম ভালো হবে। তাহলে সো উই ক্যান হ্যাভ এ মাস্ক, উই ক্যান হ্যাভ এ বাথ অলসো, ওকে? অ্যান্ড দ্য বেস্ট পার্ট, ইউ নো, ওয়েন দে গো আউট অফ দিস, out of the hospital or something, they are not with a mask, they are not with a mark, so they feel good, you know, they are like any other common people in the street. So try to see that they are not with the markings, try to see that. I know there is a constraint in life, but see whatever you can do little bit here and there to see that there are no marks.
Thank you, sir.
Sir,
and please.
Sir, I have a question. Is there any chance for a second time infection? Like if someone infected one time and he is cured, and after that, is there any chance for a second time he will be infected in COVID-19?
Very rare. It's very rare.
I think this question should be asked to a virologist rather than radiation oncologist. This is an area of
still I will reply. Debate.
Yes, sir.
This is a new virus. Let's understand that fact. We don't have a big biological history or the outcomes of this, but what sir has said is very true. That if somebody has come out with that viral disease right now, the likelihood that he'll again immediately have it is very, very uncommon. But what will happen after 2 years may not happen to have that viral infection, because the reason it he or she may have is because these viruses are known for mutation. You know, rapid mutation. So may not have the same type of viral infection, but it may have a mutated type one. Okay. So I really, really don't have the correct answer right now. Probably no, as Dr. Hay said.
জিনিস খেয়াল করতে হবে, তুমি জানো যে পেশেন্টের যারা ভালো হয়ে গেছে তাদের সিরাম দিয়ে ট্রিটমেন্ট করা হচ্ছে, সিরাম দিয়ে ট্রিটমেন্ট করে তাহলে তার ওখানে তো সিরাম সিরাম বডিতে আসে, তার এখানে সেকেন্ড টাইম যে ইনফেকশন হওয়ার চান্সটা কম থাকে।
সেক্ষেত্রে আমার এক্সট্রা কোনো প্রোটেকশন ইউজ করতে হবে?
কিছু লাগবে না, শান্তিতে থাকো, মাথা খারাপ করে
দরকার। ইউ শুড বি আওয়ার torch bearer beacon, you know. Muhammad, I'm so happy you're smiling here.
Thank you, sir.
So you should speak to all your colleagues, what was your experience and how everybody helped you. So it is now to give the time to the society, you know, at large. So please help us, please help everybody across. Okay, and now you are our super frontline worker. In case of some stress, if they call upon you, don't hesitate, you know, because the likelihood that you will have it in this point of time is very, very, sir, I said rarest of rare phenomena. Okay, I'm so happy to see you here. I wish I could physically present with you and hugged you here. I'm so happy to see you, Ismail. Muhammad Ismail Hussain. I'll remember that name. You have two gods' names are there.
Thank you, sir.
Right, am I right? My literature is a bit weak in the mythology and all those things. I am so sorry if I have crossed some line.
You are right.
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request our scientific secretary FM Kamaluddin to say a few words. And just to know everybody, it is Mr. Kamaluddin who made this program really successful. So I would like to request FM Kamaluddin sir to say a few words and conduct the next session. Thank you.
So Suman, very intelligently you have switched the ball to my court. Actually, it is the participants who made it successful. And thanks to our faculties for their valuable time. And today I want to take off and wanted Suman to take care. But he is a very smart person. So he didn't allow me to take off. So he put me in. So our schedule is up. But I think we should not go beyond 4 o'clock because I know Dr. JP have some commitment. That's why he requested me to make it within 3:45. So if there is any more question from the technologist only, we'll take it because we don't want to take, because I know many of my colleagues, radiation oncologists, have many questions to ask to Dr. JP, but due to the constraint of time, so can we take one or two questions from the technologist, then we finish it because by 4 sharp, we want to finish it because we want to maintain the time because they have a commitment, both Gurvinder and Dr. JP, they are from their clinic. Anybody? Technologist.
আমাদের কি আবার এরকম চান্স রয়ে যায় কিনা পজিটিভ হওয়ার, আবার এই প্রশ্নটা আর কি?
Make sure to take a photograph and send across everybody.
Question I did not understand the question.
So he said that he also became COVID positive. Now he is very, very cured. Okay. So
okay,
I'm
sir.
Good. I'm so happy to hear from those voices. So they are our my morale booster basically. And our morale boosters.
Jairul Islam.
Sir. স্যার আমার প্রশ্ন হচ্ছে যে আমরা যখন ট্রিটমেন্ট দেই স্যার একটা হেড নেক বোর্ডে তো স্যার হেড নেকের সব পেশেন্টই ট্রিটমেন্ট দেই সেক্ষেত্রে কোনো কারণে স্যার একটা পজিটিভ রোগী হয়তো আজকে নাই কালকে হয়ে যেতে পারে তো সেক্ষেত্রে কি স্যার এই যে হেড নেক বোর্ডটা কি প্রতিবার একটা পেশেন্ট দিয়ে কি মানে ই করা যায় স্যার এই স্যাবলুন দিয়ে বা হোক এই স্যানিটাইজার দিয়ে কি পরিষ্কার করা স্যার দরকার আছে স্যার
করতে পারলে ভালো প্রত্যেকবার করলে ভালো
হবে ডেফিনেটলি
যদি আপনি দেখবেন হিস্ট্রি অফ ভাইরাস যেদিন থেকে ওকে সিমটম হচ্ছে ওই দুদিন আগে থেকে ওরা ভাইরাস ইনফেক্টিভ হয়ে যায় তাহলে এটা বেটার হয় কি আমরা সব প্রতিদিনই আমরা ক্লিন করতে থাকি যদি সেফটি মেনটেন থাকে ঠিক আছে তাহলে ইজ এ গুড প্র্যাকটিস এন্ড It will and release ওর মধ্যে থেকে অনেক জিন আমরা অনেক জিনিসটা পাবো খালি ভাইরাস ইনফেকশন না অন্য ইনফেকশন আমরা ক্লিন করতে পারবো তাহলে এটা ভালো জিনিস বোধহয় নিউট্রোপিনিয়া যদি হয়ে যায় তাহলে কোনো কোনো সময় ইনফেকশন যদি হতো ওইটাও হবে না তাহলে এটা ভালো জিনিস কি আমরা ওইসব আমাদের হাত যা ধোয়ার প্র্যাকটিস ওইটা আমরা করা উচিত পেশেন্টকেও বোঝাওয়া উচিত ডেলি আপনার সঙ্গে যোগাযোগ হচ্ছে ওদেরকে আপনাকে সিম্পল চারটে পাঁচটা জিনিস বললে এক মিনিট লাগবে বলতে ঠিক আছে ওদের আপনার কনফিডেন্স বাড়বে আর ওদেরও আপনার উপরে কনফিডেন্স বাড়বে তাহলে ওইটা জিনিস সবসময় থাকা উচিত ঠিক আছে আর এই সময়ের পেশেন্ট অনেক স্পেশাল পেশেন্ট হবে আপনাদের লাইফে আমাদের সবার লাইফে বুঝতে পেরেছেন
জি স্যার
সবসময় মনে থাকবে আরে ওই পেশেন্টটা ওই সময় পেশেন্ট ছিল আপনাকে অনেক ভালো লাগবে ওটা দেখে ঠিক আছে
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার
ডোন্ট ওয়ারি ফর এভরি নাইট দের ইজ অলওয়েজ নেক্সট ডে ইজ কামিং ওকে সো অলওয়েজ ওয়েট ফর দ্য গুড ডে
বোরহান কোন প্রশ্ন ছিল বোরহান
আসসালামু আলাইকুম স্যার
হ্যাঁ বল
Sir, my question is, if we are treated a COVID patient, when we are treated, before 2 days, we are informed this is a COVID patient. This time, what we do?
আমি বুঝি নাই বাংলায় বলো বোরহান তোমার
কথাটা বাংলায় বলো স্যার মানে একটা পেশেন্টের মধ্যে ট্রিটমেন্ট শুরু করছে
স্যার
ওকে
আমার প্রশ্ন হচ্ছে স্যার আমরা প্রথমে জানতে পারিনি যে পেশেন্টটা কোভিড পেশেন্ট ছিল বাট আমরা ট্রিটমেন্ট করে ফেলেছি 2 থেকে 3 দিন তারপর আমরা জানতে পেরেছি যে পেশেন্টটা কোভিড এর পেশেন্ট সে সময় আমাদের করণীয়টা কি হবে এবং আমাদের যে কলিগস আছে আমাদের করণীয়টা কি হবে এটা জানতে চাইছি স্যার
গুরুইন্দর জেন্টলম্যান ইজ আস্কিং দ্যাট On the machine, I have treated a patient and after 3 days, he comes to know that the patient he treated 3 days back has become COVID positive. What he has to do or she has to do at that point of time. Am I right, Dr. Moran?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
That was the question.
Yeah, okay. very, very.
Then I take it.
Yeah, very, very, very nice question. See, this is what is happening right now because symptoms are coming after, you know, in 4 to 7 days in between. So once the day is reported that patient has got positive, so the person who is working 2 days plus or minus, those persons have to be either current guidelines says that instead of going directly for any test make them quarantine and wait for symptoms. If person is having symptoms, then definitely test can be performed. Otherwise, the advice is for quarantine.
Okay, Gurvinder. Thanks, Gurvinder. Yeah. Okay. So, Varun, আমি আপনাকে এখন বলছি এইটা মানে কি আপনারা যে আপনাকে বলেছে গুরিন্দর আই এম টকিং ইন দ্য লোকাল ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ
প্লিজ প্লিজ ক্যারি অন ইয়া
যে আপনারাকে বলেছে কি ওই পেশেন্টটা পজিটিভ হয়ে গেছে অনেক ভালো জিনিস করেছে ইট মিন্স আমাদের কন্ট্যাক্ট ট্রেসিং সিস্টেম ভালো করে চলছে ও পেশেন্টকে জিজ্ঞেস করেছে তুমি কি করেছো দুই দিন থেকে তোমরা কি কি করছো ওরা জিজ্ঞেস করে তার থেকে আপনাদের নাম কি আমার নাম এখানে এসেছে কি হ্যাঁ ইনি আপনাকে আমাকে ট্রিট করেছিলেন ঠিক আছে সো যদি আপনি আর আমরা ওকে দশ মিনিট মধ্যে সবকিছু করতে পারবো তাহলে আমরা হব লো রিস্ক টেন মিনিটস আমরা মাস্ক পরে রেখেছি আমরা হ্যান্ড ওয়াশ করেছি ওটা পেশেন্টকে দেখে সবকিছু করে তারপরে আবার হ্যান্ড ওয়াশ করেছি তাহলে আমাদের হবো লো রিস্ক দেন উই উইল বিকাম লাইক এনি আদার কমিউনিটি মেম্বার আমরা অন্য কোনো কমিউনিটি মেম্বার মতনই থাকবো যদি আমি অনেক টাইম দেখেছি আমি মাস্ক যদি পরে না থাকি তাহলে আমি বিকামস আমি হয়ে যাই হাই রিস্ক উই আমাদেরকে হেলথ কেয়ার ওয়ার্কার্সকে we should avoid becoming high risk mr prashant amara ekta limited capacity ache to amader hospital re amader life e institution e to amra low risk is acceptable norm high risk is not a good practice mr prashant prothom jinish ta tale jodi ami high risk achi tale ekta principle thake ami ekta quarantine e jete hobe amaderke ঠিক আছে কোয়ারেন্টাইনে আমাকে দেখবে ওরা কি আমি সিমটম আছে কি সিমটম নেই যদি আমাদের কোনো সিমটম হয় আমরা টেস্ট করব কিন্তু অন্য অন্য কান্ট্রিতে অন্য অন্য ইনস্টিটিউশনতে একটু পলিসি তফাত হতে পারে মানে কি আপনারা হাই রিস্ক যদি আমি আপনারা কি হাই রিস্ক হয়ে যায় আমাদেরকে ওরা 7 to 10 days ওইখানে থাকবে আর আমাকে টেস্ট করবে যদি আমরা থাকি তাহলে আবার আমাদেরকে কাজে আসতে হবে কেন তো লিমিটেড হেলথ ওয়ার্কার আছি তো আমরা তার জন্য আমাদেরকে ওই ডিসিশনটা নিতে হয় কি এটা লো রিস্ক হাই রিস্ক কাজে আনতে পারি কি না আনতে পারি যদি কোমরবিডিটি থাকলে তাহলে আমি আরো 10 দিন পরে আবার টেস্ট করব লেস কোমরবিডিটি আমি উইদিন 14 days 10 days আমি টেস্ট করে আবার ওনাকে কাজে নিয়ে আনতে পারি ওকে বলুন ইউ গট ইওর আনসার
ওকে সো ওকে
Oncology Club always was trying to focus on all the component of the cancer caregiver. We are not focusing on only one community, that's why we make program for oncologists, we make program for physicists, and we never forget our RTT technologists who are the main person who treat our patient, because we believe that you are a part of our team. And we are so proud that if you remember in our all program, always the senior most radiation oncologist came in IAEA program as faculty for RTT, because they also give you the value. So don't think that you are not an important person, you are the most important person in the whole team. And that's why we have done this special program for radiation technologies and Oncology Club. This is the first program that we have done for focusing on COVID. And the only program we did is for radiation therapy technologies. And it is the instruction of our president and secretary who has done it. And thanks to our two faculty, Dr. JP and Gurvinder, both of them are extremely busy. This is their office day. They have taken out precious 1 hour time from their office hour, thanks to you. And we understand that how you value our radiotherapy technologies. You have proved it many times and this time. Thank you very much. And I know that we can take more questions, but due to the limitation of time, we cannot take any more questions. And we want to finish it today. And inshallah, we all will remain, try to remain safe, and we will remain safe because our safety is the safety, not for me, but for my family and also for my patients. Because we have, as Dr. JP said, country like us has very limited people like you to treat, but a huge number of patients to be treated. So for the huge number of patients, we cannot take the risk of losing you, even to quarantine you. So you need to be very cautious and very calculative and follow the four rules of radiation. What Dr. JP said, that the follow the rule of radiation that will that shield you, distance, time, and that principle will save you from infection. So with these few words and with the permission of my president, we want to conclude the session, and inshallah we will meet again in a better time, in a better environment to discuss. Thank you very much, and again heartfelt thanks. And we will be sending the email with the link of the recorded version and also the presentation to all the participants. So whoever is interested at night, they can see the program again, and also they can enjoy the presentation of Gurvinder. Thank you.